Getting to space is hard. Right now, it's like going up a mountain on a unicycle with a backpack full of explosives. Incredibly slow, you can't transport a lot of stuff, and you might die. A rocket needs to reach a velocity of about 40,000 kilometers an hour to escape from Earth. To get to that speed, rockets are mostly containers for fuel with a tiny tip of payload. This is bad if you want to go to other planets, because you need a lot of heavy stuff if you want to survive and maybe even come back. So is there a way to get to space with less fuel and more payload? A nice thing that solved most of our transport problems on Earth is what you call infrastructure. Whether it's roads for cars, ports for ships, or rails for trains, we've made it easier to get to places. We can apply the same solution to space travel. Space infrastructure will make getting into orbit and out to the Moon, Mars, and beyond easier and cheaper. Great, but what exactly is space infrastructure? Unlike an Earth space elevator, which is currently science fiction, there is a simple yet promising technology that does not require...
There are some people trying to come up with ways of doing the space elevator with a twist. I mean, actually, I think this is what this video is about. The cable, I wasn't sure if he was meaning one of those things in orbit that spin like this, and you launch stuff up and it gets like jolted and boosted. I thought that's what this was about, but this actually looks like it's about the stuff I was about to bring up. That dangle from space, and you park it in a place where it doesn't move from, and a cable, and then so you have to get to the cable, which is not too high up, and then you pull yourself up.
Vader, which is currently science fiction, there is
a... You can also dangle it from the moon.
Simple yet promising technology that does not require new science, magic materials, or huge investments, and that has been tested successfully in orbit already. A cable and a weight, known as a tether. The concept is so simple, it's surprising. What if we put tethers, hundreds or thousands of kilometers long, into space, and had spacecraft use them as ladders to climb to higher altitudes and gain speed? This concept is known as the Skyhook. It works even better if we make it spin. A counterweight holds...
Okay, so I'm just out of date with this stuff. But the versions I've seen, you could literally dangle it nearly almost to the ground.
A long cable in place while it rotates around a circle. A rotating tether slows down its tip relative to the ground at the bottom and speeds it up at the top like a catapult. This means that you can transfer energy from the tether and get a massive boost when released.
So this is just fundamentally different to the cable I'm talking about. The cable, you know, be dangled down, and so you hook onto it, and it would be like an elevator, and then you get pulled up. Whereas this one is clearly more of a boost, you know, to get out.
More or less for free, equal to twice the tether's rotation velocity. Specialized fibers already exist that can survive the extraordinary stresses a Skyhook would be faced with.
Graphene.
To protect against cuts and collisions from debris and meteorites, we can thread our tether into a web of redundant fibers. Since our Skyhook would pass over the same spot many times a day, this would allow small, reusable shuttles to catch up with it. Of course, it's not that easy. At its lowest point, the tether's tip is dashing through the atmosphere at around 12,000 kilometers per hour. Because of Earth's atmosphere, we can't lower the Skyhook too much, or it will get too hot from air friction. So it will dip to a height of 8.
You could, if the material was very thin and stuff like this. And that's why some have put forward the idea of this very thin stuff made out of graphene, where you only need, like, you know, an atom's thick, and an elephant could balance on a pin and it wouldn't break or some shit like that.
80 to 150 kilometers and no lower. To match this, we'll need specialized spacecraft that can get to the tether. While this isn't exactly easy, it's still much cheaper than getting a big tin can filled with rocket fuel to go 40,000 kilometers an hour.
So much easier and so much cheaper.
Catching the tip will be a challenge too. There's only a short time window of 60 to 90 seconds to find a tiny thing in the sky moving at Mach 12. To make this easier, the tip could have a sort of fishing line, a kilometer long, with a navigation drone that helps the spacecraft connect. Another challenge is keeping our Skyhook in orbit. As more and more ships latch onto it and pull themselves up, they use up the momentum that keeps it in place. If we don't do anything, it will slow down and crash into the atmosphere. And here, we can cheat the universe a bit. The Skyhook is a battery.
That's why you dangle it from the moon.
...of orbital energy. It's possible to balance the payloads coming in and being sent off. Arriving ships bringing humans and materials home to Earth add energy to the tether, which it can give to other ships departing into space. This way, the tether doesn't lose any energy. The more...
Genius.
...the more we use it, the cheaper it gets. If we're still losing energy with each boost, we can recover it with small electric or chemical engines that regularly correct the tether's position. A set of tethers, one around Earth and one around Mars, could make trips between the planets fast, straightforward, and low-cost compared to rockets. The Earth tether would sit in low Earth orbit to grab people and payloads and fling them off to Mars. The Mars tether catches them and slows them down for a landing on the surface.
Brilliant. We should do this. And we're just going to pause here so I can tell you guys to come check out my new kind of VPN, a post-quantum VPN. And you should come get it. The beta is out now. So come get it and help us colonize Venus one day. But yeah, new kind of VPN can protect you from powerful quantum computers, which are going to be a problem, I predict, in about 3 years. Definitely 5 years. So it's worth getting now. Capture, decrypt later is going to be a big problem. Hackers could be stealing data right now, and you could decrypt it at these later times. But anyway, let's get back to the video.
In the opposite direction, the tether could pick up a vehicle traveling through Mars's thin atmosphere at only about 1,000 kilometers an hour, not much faster than our airliners on Earth, and fling it back to Earth to be caught and lowered down. The tethers could shorten trips...
They wouldn't be too bad, Ponyboy, I don't think.
...between both planets from 9 months down to 5 or even 3, and...
These people definitely have calculated these things.
...reduce the scale of the rockets required by between 84 and 96%. Even better, people may be able to travel in relative luxury, as we could afford to invest in passenger comfort. Tether travel would be first-class seats to Mars. Together, tethers around Earth and Mars could provide the rapid and cost-efficient transportation backbone that would make space travel affordable. But let's go further.
This is such a good video. No, I'm not convinced nuking Mars will terraform it. It could, but we don't know if nuking it's going to restart the magnetic field. You know, we think Earth's magnetic field is coming from the fact there's all this charged metal flowing around in the cores, around the core and stuff, and that's generating a magnetic field around the planet, we think, right? And so with Mars, which is a smaller planet, it doesn't have a magnetic field, and so we think maybe the core has stopped or something to do with the core, and the core is a little bit different. You know, just nuking this place might not actually help generating the magnetic field, which you kind of need if you want to have, you know, a sustainable atmosphere and things like this. The science just isn't there. So, you know, maybe it's worth a try. But then again, I kind of want to see what's under the ground of Mars as well. You know, there could be ancient life and things like that we'd destroy if we just nuked it.
Starting from low Mars orbit, a tether could boost ships to the asteroid belt. The first craft sent to a new asteroid would need rockets to slow
Did
down.
Did you guys see NASA just planned a trip to a quadrillion-dollar asteroid? Asteroid worth more than the global economy. $10 quadrillion. Holy dooly. Was set to launch in August 2022. Will arrive at the asteroid in 2026. However, the software issues, they should have got CalVPN. They got hacked. I'm just kidding. Problems that meant the mission missed its window. An internal continuation termination review. So when is it replanned? No earlier than October 2023. That's exciting.
Its destination. Subsequent arrivals might find a tether waiting to catch them and send them back for free. Getting to asteroids cheaply is a major factor in opening up the resources of the solar system. Precious metals and valuable minerals could be delivered to Mars just weeks after they were cut out of their asteroid. They would be the perfect building blocks for our interplanetary civilization. But why stop here? Mars moons are very convenient. No other moons in the solar system orbit that close to their planet. Phobos is so heavy that we don't need to worry about slowing it down, making it the perfect attachment point for supertethers just under 6,000 kilometers long. The lower tip would fly just over the surface of Mars and be very easy to catch. The upper tip can fling ships all the way to Jupiter and Saturn. The same super tether can also bring the inner solar system closer. Venus and Mercury are a single swing away. Unlike Mars, they're bursting with solar energy and are rich in minerals. In the long term, nothing is stopping humanity from constructing a zero-propellant transport network for the terrestrial planets centered on the Martian moons. Tethers are a comparably cheap and sustainable solution to making space travel affordable and the rest of the solar system accessible for exploitation and exploration. Considering that we have the technology to build them today, there's really no good excuse to wait any longer. Parts of the solar system are far away, but they could be very close.
Maybe I should dedicate some time to trying to create a company, and we're trying to create a Skyhook. That could be fun. Because like you just said, there's no reason we couldn't build one right now. No one seems to be trying to. Because everyone's just concerned with making businesses that make money, right? Maybe I can put a proposal to try and get it some funding to, suggest we'll make it to these quadrillion dollar asteroids and we'll bring you back the dollars. Just let us make our damn Skyhook. That could actually be a really good idea. You know, that's kind of what Elon has tried to do with SpaceX. Obviously, there's more problems than just creating the Skyhook. You'd have to, how do you get the material? You'd have to create one at the asteroid. You get bugger all of YouTube. But it actually could be worthwhile for a future thing. And, you know, them working in conjunction with SpaceX. Might sound crazy and far off, but I wouldn't be surprised if a company like that pops up relatively soon.
Speaking of stuff that's hard to reach, but doesn't...
Well, that's that video. I love Kurzgesagt's videos. Amazing.